Were lack of reserve funds at Champlain Towers South a contributing factor to the collapse? As the founder and CEO of Association Reserves, the nation's largest reserve study provider, that's the most common question I've been asked in the last few weeks. It's quite revealing that the combined physical and financial state of the building was known prior to its collapse. In this video, I will state, as I have so often recently, the four industry best practices that guide your building towards aging gracefully and safely. I will also share the most common and avoidable reserve funding mistakes I see boards continuing to make. Well, thank you, Adrian. I think you're going to hear a lot of similar themes from all four of us. But we've been getting a number of questions in our area of specialty, which is reserves. And many ask if just the reserve studies themselves are going to keep the building well-maintained. Well, best practice is that four things are required to keep buildings, older condos, in good condition. One is that the board needs to regularly update the reserve study to get fresh information, because every year it gets further out of date. Number two, the board needs to fund the recommendations per the reserve study. Number three, the board needs to spend based on the recommendation for accomplishing projects in the reserve study. And there's a fourth part of best practice in keeping older condos in good condition. A reserve study identifies the regular cyclical projects. And as recommended in the CAI Research Foundation's recent aging infrastructure report that was published in early 2020, it's in the best interest of an association to also have a periodic infrastructure inspection report by a qualified structural engineer or architect. And that inspection identifies the difference, the important difference between a minor cosmetic crack, something that can be covered by paint, or something that's a significant deterioration issue that's going to result in major repairs. And we already see those types of inspections already, at least in three regions. California has an exterior elevated elements inspection requirement every 9 years. We know about the 40-year inspection report that's required by two counties in the state of Florida. And there's also a 5-year facade inspection report in New York City. So that needs to be accompanied with a reserve study. And then we got a lot of questions about how often should you update your reserve study. Well, a good practice is a WSSITE visit update every third year with annual adjustments and tweaks in the years in between. That's what we find an effective balance between the cost of reserve study updates and the danger of just letting the budget drift for years and years at a time. We also had a number of questions on the topic of how much should the association be setting aside in reserves. Well, that's going to be different for every building, and it's a number that's found in the reserve study.
That's Robert, actually, I have a question on that. Sure. Champlain Towers, what was their reserve funding level?
That's an answer to the next question. They were 6.9% funded. Well, let me go right to that. How does someone know how much reserves they have at their association? Well, it's now public record that Champlain Towers South had about $700,000 in reserves. And to the average person, that sounds like a lot of money. But the reserve needs of the property at that time were about $10 million. So what's important at any point in time is the comparison between how much cash the association have and their reserve needs. And that comparison is called the percent funded. And it's now known that the Champlain Tower South reserve fund was 6.9% funded. That's in the 0 to 30% weak range, where special assessments and deferred maintenance are common. The 30 to 70% range is the fair range, where special assessments are infrequent. And the percent funded over 70% means that the property is in a combined strong physical and financial condition. And that's where special assessments are rare. So our recommendation is check your reserve study and check to see what range your association's percent funded is in.
Yeah, Robert, let me add that.
Sure.
On the percent funding that is that low, 6.9, I've dealt with associations that have been in the 7 to 12% funding range. And they ended up with really large special assessments and then getting sued for having not properly funded the reserves and imposing such a large special assessment on the membership. So I've been involved in a number of lawsuits where boards have been sued because of that. So the funding is really important, and boards need to pay particular attention to it because they may be targeted in lawsuits for failure to properly fund their reserves.
Yeah, it gets into the question of what's a board member to know? And we're not asking significant things of board members. My aunt was the president of her association in Florida for, I think, a decade. She has administrative skills. She was an office worker for many years. We're not asking special things of board members, but they need to know what your numbers are. And you talked about that in the business judgment rule, the duty of inquiry, the reaching out for information. And that's part of the questions we've been getting, you know, how much should we contribute? And that answer is found in the reserve study. There's three results in any reserve study. What the components are that defines the scope and schedule of reserve projects, the reserve fund strength, that's the percent funded, and the recommended funding plan. And that's where you get your recommended contributions. And again, a number of people have asked us, what's the, if you had a magic wand, what's the biggest reserve mistake that needs to be corrected? And I would agree with you, Adrian, that boards need to adequately fund reserves. Ongoing deterioration is expensive. The roof doesn't send a deterioration bill each month, but that's a bill just like all other bills that needs to be paid. So our encouragement is to break the chain of poor decisions at your association and start making appropriately sized reserve contributions. That way you'll have the funds to make those timely repair and replacements. So boards need to stop focusing on the fool's gold of low monthly assessments and start focusing on their job, which is providing for the budget to provide for the needs of the association.
At Association Reserves, we make the present less stressful and the future more secure. If you want to join us in this mission, please like this video and subscribe to our channel. Leave a comment down below on what you'd like to see us address in a future video. Let's plan for your best future.